You should come to hell with me someday. I'm a monster. No. No, they're the monsters. Everyone calls me sick. Well, they're sick. Their complaints about dropped calls and thread count. Why is it not my blood? I didn't save the world, what kind of goddamn world is it to save?
Thank you. Thank you. job, but with no mail.
Thank God you're such a hero.
I have to learn this out of
here. I'm so sorry.
Thank you.
Thank you.
have to learn this out of
I'm so sorry.
You have to learn.
Thank you.
I've been running from my past for so long that I forgot what its face looked like. I see it now. I see it in the faces of my brothers and sisters. I see it in the faces of those I killed. When I killed my first, I died with him, you know. With every drop spilled afterwards, I felt like I became less human and more something else. Once you understand that death is breathing down your neck, flirting with your friends, cradling your hands around a trigger, you just can't come back from that. Mistakes sometimes look like victories, and victories sometimes become mistakes. In the end, it's all just blood and war, and yet you live them over and over and over again. Thing is, I never came home from war, but this other monster did. This monster doesn't belong in civilian life. I was a prisoner in my own rage and self-loathing, trapped by nightmares and constant fear. Any noise, smell, or sight could push me off a ledge into hell. The roller coaster at that carnival must have been a real doozy. All I remember is hearing the screams and then feeling nothing but excruciating confusion. Smothering it all in something else seemed like a good idea. It wasn't. It helped take the edge off, but only pushed me further into the darkness. I didn't care. I hated everyone. All those ungrateful idiots who could never understand what those who lost their souls went through to protect them. And yet I so longed to be part of it again. I lost myself. I was a ghost within shadows. I know I'm not alone. I know I can get help if I ask. The ghosts won't stop following me no matter how much I try to forget or exercise them with drugs and booze. Perhaps now I can reach out my hand. Not for spare change, but for backup. I guess I could use a little backup for this one last battle.
I appreciate the concern and all your efforts, but all this is quite excessive. Let's be candid here. I have Alzheimer's. Mistakes are to be expected. This thing that happened at the performance, not knowing where I was, it was mortifying. Yes, I'm embarrassed, ashamed even. But I suppose that's just my new reality now. My most prestigious days are behind me. What happened there is just the new normal. Swallowing a mistake like that. Ever since I was a child, My motto was always, pain makes you worthy. Perfection makes it worth it. So yes, I feel guilt. Who wouldn't? Especially someone in my position. But to call it excessive? Erratic? Obsessive? Look, my friends and colleagues, they mean well, but they simply don't understand. They never have. I built my whole life in pursuit of perfection. Once you've experienced true perfection, nothing less will ever do. That performance. I failed the audience. I failed the orchestra. I failed myself. I failed everyone who has depended on me because I made a terrible mistake. The first, no doubt, of many to come. And there is not a goddamn thing you, me, or any of your technologies or techniques can do about it. I can work through my problems on my own. I always have. Furthermore, to be frank, the suggestion that trauma has anything to do with this is a tremendous overreaction. Just stop wasting your time on me. At this point, why does any of it matter anyway? Well, here we are. There is more to this fading old gal than I thought. That performance where I forgot where I was, it wasn't about the Alzheimer's. It wasn't even about being perfect or about me as a performer. It was about fear. Perhaps my whole life's work has been about fear. Fear of failure. Fear of Mr. Oh. My piano instructor as a child berating me over and over and then slamming the whole board on my hands. Even after he had long since left my life, I still felt something in the pit of my stomach every time I reach for the keys. Curious how I forgot that moment, and yet its ghost continued to haunt me, pushing me, chasing me really to the greatest heights, taking its toll on my spirit with every step, every perfect performance. I wonder if the ghost too will fade along with everything else. Perhaps the Alzheimer's will provide that one final mercy. But even if it doesn't, I feel a sense of rest now. Refreshed, like when you air out a dusty room. I suppose healing will take time. I don't know how much of that I have left. The song of my life may be reaching its conclusion, but I now feel certain of this. It will be ending on a high note. Thank you, Doctor. Thank you for this most precious gift.